Let me ask you something. Do you spend more time creating mockups for your Tumblr app than actually designing those app? If that sounds like you are in the right place. Because in today's video, I'll teach you how you can easily automate the entire mockup creation process for your 40-ounce Tumblr app. And to just demonstrate how powerful the automation will be, let me show you the whole automation process for 20 designs that I have here. Now let me show you how you can do this for your workflow. Let's dive in. To automate the mockup creation process for 40-ounce Tumblr app, we'll be using Photoshop and Bulk Mockup plugin. The first step in the process is setting up your mockup templates the right way. What you see on your screen are two different templates. The first one that we'll be setting it up is a Canva transparent PNG template that I had purchased from Etsy. So I'll open this up in Photoshop, and this is what you get. There's a transparency with shadows and highlight. So now we'll create two smart object layers, one for the top of the Tumblr and one for the bottom of the Tumblr. So before I jump in and create a smart object, let me open up the design files that I have for this project. So these are the design files. I have both bottom as well as top design. I'll just right click and click on get info. If you are in Windows, right click and click on details. What I want to find out is the size of this design file. So the size is 3750-1740. So I'll go back to Photoshop. On the Photoshop, I'll select this rectangle tool and then click at the center. Now it asks me for a width and the height. So I'll enter the width and the height looking at the value that we have here, which is 3750, and height I'll enter it as 1740, and then I'll hit on OK. So it will create a rectangle, so do not worry if it goes beyond the canvas size. Select this rectangle layer on the right click and click on convert to smart object. Go grab the move tool here and then just hold this layer rectangle one and you can position at the center. Again, it goes beyond the Photoshop canvas. Keeping the rectangle one as an active, press Ctrl T and then it will activate the anchor points. Take your cursor, mouse cursor to the anchor points and reduce the size. Next, I want you to rename this rectangle one. Yeah, so you'll right click and click on rename layer and we'll name this as top. We'll rename it as top and we'll move this top layer underneath layer one. Just hold and drag it. Next, I'll press Ctrl T and you can see the bounding box for this rectangle. We'll try to reduce it and fit the blank spaces in this Tumblr mockup that we have. So I'll try to squeeze in from all the side. Now, if I go any further, you'll see the transparency layers over here. We do not want this. So again, drag it back and try to position it from all the regions. And whenever you see some transparency, just go back. And then once you are satisfied with the positioning, just click on this check mark or hit enter on your keyboard. So we have the top part. Now we'll create the smart object for the bottom part. Again, I'll go back to our design folder and again, I'll grab this one, right click and click on get info. For Windows, you can go to right click, go to details and then properties, and then you'll find those dimension region. So these are the dimension for the bottom part. I'll again grab this rectangle tool, click at the center. It asks me for the width and height. This time around it is 3162. And the height is 1103 pixels. I'll hit on OK. Again, I'll right click and convert it into a smart object. And this time it is top. We'll right click and click on rename layer and name this bottom. Renaming the layer is very important in this whole setup, so just do not ignore this step. I'll drag, it's already underneath layer 1, so I'll press Ctrl T to activate the anchor points, and then you can drag it to position it in the bottom part of the mug. I'll reduce the size and try to position it at the center. If I reduce any further, you'll see the transparencies, so just ignore that. I'll hit on the check mark. So our template is ready. It was very simple to do. We have two smart object layers, bottom and then top. Next, I'll go ahead and save this as a Photoshop file. So I'll save it. Tumblr PNG, we'll name it as PST, and then I'll save it. Now you can close this up. Now, so this is the PNG file. I'll delete this now. Next, we'll open up this template. This is a very beautifully created template that I purchased from Etsy. If you want to get a hand on this template, there will be a link in the description. So when you open this template, there is group 1 and then mockup front view. Whenever you are confused like which layer we need to modify or edit to get the Tumblr design, just turn off the visibility eye icon and you'll be able to find out which layer we are supposed to focus on. So for this template, just open this, click on this arrow, it will open the further layers, and then we have different groups. We have straws, straw shadows and highlight, and then finally the cups. So if I open this cup, now we further have right cup, left cup, middle cup. So the beautiful thing about this mockup template is that all the smart object layers in this template are linked. I'll not go deep into how the linking happens, but in this template, what we are supposed to do is, I'll go open this right cup. We have three smart object layers here, our top, our bottom, our middle. So if you remember from the previous template, I asked you to rename the smart object layers properly. We renamed this top and then bottom. Now in this template, we'll have to follow the same naming convention. So this is a top. So I'll just right click and click on rename layers. I'll delete the R. Then again for the bottom part, I'll right click and rename the layers. I'll rename it as bottom. Remember, the naming should exactly match in verbatim. There should be no spaces as well. Now we have top and then bottom. For the top, I'll right click and click on edit contents. But again, this is a smart object layer. Right click and we'll rename this as at nested. Save this, Ctrl S to save, close this. Again, we'll open the bottom smart object layer, right click, click on edit contents. I'll rename this as at nested. So there is another layer here. I'll delete this one. Let it be only one layer. We'll rename it as at nested. Save it and close this part. And then we can close this entire setup, save it, close this. Now these two templates are properly set up for our mockup automation. The next step in this automation process is to set up your design folders in a proper manner. So let us go back to our design folder. So these are the designs that I have. I have 60 of them and they're all spread across top, bottom, top, bottom. Okay. So if you remember, we created two smart object layers in the template. Now, in the design folder, we'll create two folders with the same name as the smart object layer name. So I'll create a new folder. I'll name it top. Then I'll create another folder. I'll name this bottom. Now, these two subfolders should exactly match with the spelling as well, with the capital letters, small letters, everything. And then, now sort all your design folders. So, top will go in the top. So, take your time and segregate all the design file into top and bottom folder. So now I have segregated our design file into two subfolders. If I open up, we have all the bottom designs over here. I have 420 of them. And then I have the top designs here. 20 of them. Now we have segregated our design files into two subfolders, bottom and top. Now let's jump onto the final stage of the automation, that is using the Bulk Mockup plugin. So Bulk Mockup is an incredible Photoshop plugin. That you'll see how easily it automates the whole process. You can go check out more detail about Bulk Mockup plugin at bulkmockup.com. Now let's jump into Photoshop. We'll go to plugins and click on Bulk Mockup. So this is how the plugin window looks like. We have the main tab. On the main tab, we have three fields: PST template folder, design folders, and export folder. So again, I'll go back to the folders that we had. So we have a template folder which has all the templates. Then we have the design folder which has two subfolders. So I'll go and create another folder here. I'll name it export. Now I'll go back to Photoshop. So first is PST template folder. Click on the browse icon. We'll select the template folder. Next we'll select the design file folder. This is a design folder. I'll click on open. Next we have export folder. We'll select the export, hit on open. Now we have this icon, process multiple smart objects. Just check on this. Remember, we had two smart object layers in the template, and this feature in the Bulk Mockup will help us automate both the smart object layers. For the resize method, we'll select fit canvas, cropping the extra. Then we'll go to the settings. I'll just show you around. On the settings, we have design layer. We'll keep the setting as it is over here. Then we'll go to PST template, is all good. Next, we'll go to the export option. Then from the export, we'll go to folders. And over here, let me select all in export folder. If you want to organize your export into, subfolders, you may select design file. For the files, we want the JPG output, so I'll select only JPG. These are the different file format options that you can opt for. For the naming, I think this looks good. For the naming, let us add the design file name. I think that naming looks good now. Now we'll go back to the main tab. I'll reduce the Photoshop window and I'll put the export folder on the side here so that we can actually see live how the automation process works. Now this is the Bulk Mockup plugin. I'll hit on start generating and the magic will start. So it opens up the first mockup template and it's actually adding the designs top and the bottom, and we'll see the output just over here. So we have the output top and bottom. So the Bulk Mockup process is already in place, and I could go and do my course. I'm receiving a call from my wife here. I'll just pick up this call, and yeah, that's how easy Bulk Mockup is. Now this is the Bulk Mockup process. As you can look, these are the mockups that are generated within minutes. So that is how you automate the creation of mockup for a 40 ounce tumbler rack. If you have any questions, drop them in the comment. If you want to check the plugin, go to bulkmockup.com. And thank you for watching this video. See you in the next one.